comfort zone. It's been about trying new things. It's about going where I haven't been before. For example, when I was a child, I thought it would be a fantastic idea if me and some friends painted our bodies completely. Then we thought, you know what we should do? We should go down to the supermarket, just do some shopping. Okay, so here we are walking through the supermarket, completely blue, no shirts. And then just to take things that a little bit further, we bought a sound system. You know, the sound system? And we played the song, I'm blue, ba-dee-ba-ba-ba. And we did the robot, just to see how people would respond.
What better place to start than the beginning?
let's just get to bed.
Hey, I get up. I get up. I get back to sleep.
9 a.m.
I get up.
I get up. 10 a.m. I get up. And I think to myself, why the hell am I not out of bed yet? Today is my big day. I'm going off into the unknown. I'm being a strong man. And here I am, sleeping in my bed. So by the time I arrived in Girona, which was my start point, it was actually 2 o'clock. And I was thinking through my mind, why did it take me so long to get out of bed? Does anyone have any ideas why it might have taken me so long to get out
of bed? You have a hangover?
Yes, quite possible. No, not in this situation. Yeah? Any other ideas?
You need illusions.
What's that?
You need illusions.
I need illusions. Okay, oh yes. Sort of. I was fucking terrified. I was afraid, okay? I've never hitchhiked before in my life. I was about to travel for 2 weeks, not knowing what the next, 5 seconds is going to bring. I was completely afraid. I was procrastinating. So then, as I'm walking up to the highway, I'm thinking, well, I'm walking up to the highway. Why don't I just put my thumb out now? Why do I need to get to the highway to start putting my thumb out? Okay. So I decide to do it. It's okay. Can anyone guess how long it took me to get my first ride? Okay, any other guesses?
An hour,
okay. 20 minutes? Try 3 minutes. 3 minutes of putting my thumb out, and this beautiful Spanish family pull over. They've got a baby in the back. Turns out that these people are professional hitchhikers. Okay? Professional hitchhikers. Okay? These people would have competitions with their friends. Okay, they get into pairs. They say, okay, first person to Madrid wins. So they had different couples, different teams who would race each other going to different cities. So this was a fantastic start to my adventure. And I really learned something important here. And it was, sometimes when you want something, you can do research for as long as you want. Think, okay, I want to start this business, I'm going to do some more research. I'm going to find out who I need to talk to. Okay? But nothing actually happens until you put your thumb out, until you make that call, until you speak to that person. Okay? I could be researching best techniques on how to hitchhike for hours, but that wouldn't actually take me any closer to arriving in Croatia. So I learned something important there. If you really want something to happen, you've got to step. You have to put your thumb out. You have to take that action. Yeah. So my friends took me across the border into the French side. If you could show the next photo. Okay. This is a Spanish family. Had a baby in the back there. And then I arrived, in France. And the sun was going down. Okay. And I had two options. I could, one, go into the city, try and find a place to sleep. Or I could, too, continue hitching as the night was coming. Any ideas on which option I went for it? Second option? You got me. Alright. It was already late. I had not travelled as far as I needed to go. And I thought, okay, I need to try again. I need to keep going. Any ideas on how long this one took?
Probably.
We're now in France, I'm not saying yes, I'm just saying, okay, yeah. Any other ideas? A couple of hours? Try 5 minutes. What is going on here? How easy is this? This is not even difficult. What my friends are telling me is, this is easy. It was a Moroccan architect, who'd been living in France for all of his life. And what I realized on our journey is that somebody's car is like a very personal space. It's almost like their bedroom. You know, they sit in it every morning, they listen to their favorite music, they sing in there, they, you know, have their friends in there, they have good times inside the car. So they are very comfortable people when they're in the car. And when people are feeling comfortable, you have the ability to connect. Okay? You're not like in a social situation. How are you? You know, what do you do? These stupid questions. You really got the chance to like meet this guy. Which put us into a strange situation when I needed to go. It was our moment to say goodbye. We were friends now. And now he's like, okay, well, see you later. And then off I go, you know, into this dark, unknown, like emotionless highway. Okay? And I could see on his face, you know, how scared he was. He was scared. This is something that he would probably never do. He was going back home to be with his family, to be comfortable. And here I am, his friend, going into the black, going into the darkness. So we shared a very, very interesting moment there.
So I'll be right, you know, I'll just go over here and just find something.
Totally lost. Okay, so let's go for the next photo. This is the guy here. Really nice guy. Okay. So, if we can press the next. Yeah, this is where I slept for the first night. Okay. This was a construction site. Okay, so they were building new buildings there. It was next to the highway. Okay. And you know, as I lay down after my massive day, I just thought to myself,
oh my god,
today was absolutely. Tomorrow, the suit comes out. Okay. I had promised my friends, and I had promised myself, that I was going to do a little experiment. I was going to see if more people would help me hitch if I wore a business suit. Or would more people help me hitch if I was wearing normal clothes? Okay. Go for the next photo.
This is me in the morning,
feeling very confident. Thankfully, there was no construction, you know, worker who came in the morning. So,
what are you doing here? You know?
Nobody came, thankfully. So now it's 7 o'clock in the morning. I'm in France. I'm wearing my suit, and you know, standing here. Can anyone guess how long this one took? This is the first time using the suit. We're in France. This is 7 o'clock in the morning, where there are lots of business professionals, you know, on their way to work. Any ideas?
1 hour.
1 hour, okay, yeah, 1 hour.
7 minutes.
7 minutes? Very close.
3 to 5 to 7. It's 2 minutes more every time.
Yeah, you're working something out there. Yeah, try 8 minutes, okay? 8 minutes, this black Mercedes-Benz SL500, which is like the top. Black windows, you know, comes over and like, damn, this suit works good. Wow, this is luxury. This is better than traveling in a bus. I only wait eight minutes and I'm driving in Mercedes-Benz style. This is good. And I walk up to the Mercedes-Benz feeling very confident. You know, I knock on the window. And as I knock, I see that they're looking at their GPS. They're not even looking at me. So these guys are lost. They didn't even realize I was looking for a ride. And here I am on the window. They wind the window down. Hello, do you think I could... Oh, which way are you going?
So, oh, sorry, no space, no space.
They didn't even respond. They just didn't want to talk to you. Okay. So what I did, I just said, okay, I just hope you have a fantastic day. Right. Just enjoy yourselves. Left it there. I'm not gonna push, come on, let me in your car, I wanna ride, give me a ride. Let them be. I said what I needed to say, and they weren't ready for that, and I let them be. Back I go. All these business professionals giving me like weird looks in their faces, seeing another businessman, each one. Is this for real? And
sir.
I hear from the car. Hey, monsieur! Hey, monsieur! I think we found some space for you!
I think we found some space for you. So somehow there's new space that's just appeared magically. But I wasn't going to question that, okay?
Well, no, where did this place come from? I was going to be very grateful.
And that started a new journey. If we can get the next one.
This is the team here.
We actually drove for 8 hours together. And during this experience, I somehow, you know, they had a baby in the back. I became like part-time babysitter, you know, helping the baby, playing games there, having conversations with both of them. And over this 8 hour period, I sort of like became their child in a way. Like, not, you know, but they really cared for me. They looked after me. They paid for my lunch. They gave me water. They gave me food. They answered all of my questions. So once again, it's amazing what can happen when you just open yourself to the world. So when I arrived in Cannes, they didn't want to let me go. They said, well, where are you staying tonight? Where are you going to sleep? I said, well, you know, I'll find somewhere. I'll just do something and find a place to sleep. That's what I do. They said, no, we have an apartment here. You can sleep on our couch, no problems. You know, we'll cook you dinner. No problem. Well, that's a very nice offer. But I'd like some time just to think about it. So, off they go. I go down to the beach, have my first shower. Okay? In the water. What a day. Okay, if we can go for the next slide. Okay, Cannes. Has anybody been to Cannes before? What is Cannes like?
Very rich and beautiful.
Rich. What do you mean by rich?
Full of rich people.
Well described, yes. Sean. Fantastic. Yes, so it's full of money. There's a massive focus on money. There's big boats, there's massive cars, everybody's wearing, you know, Louis Vuitton, it's like a fashion parade constantly. And then there's this guy with his backpack walking through the streets of Cannes. Okay. So what I was thinking, I'd now like to get you guys thinking a little bit. Okay. So let's click over to the next one. Okay, next one. Okay, we're going to talk a little bit about fears with the English language. Okay, does anybody have a little fear with the English language or something that they would like to improve but they always like don't really focus on or they don't do it today, they do it another day? Any things that they would like to improve? For example, speaking English in front of groups of people. Some people might have a fear of that, or a little bit of difficulty with that. Another one, pronunciation. Maybe it's one of those things that sometimes we just don't focus on. We always, you know, pronounce it better tomorrow, do it later. Okay. Studying outside of class. I know you all study outside of class. So that's studying grammar. That's another one. So now what I'd like to get you guys doing is to think about something that you would like to improve. Something within the English language that maybe you have a fear of it. Maybe you just never do it, but you know that you want to do it. Yeah? Yeah? Okay. I'm going to hand you this little piece of paper here. This wasn't just a speech, guys. You know. Get us thinking. Okay. Speaking of pronunciation. action we can take this week that will push us into the unknown, or push us in the direction of improving that. Okay? So we want to get three different advices from people next to you, near you, about one action we can take to go towards becoming better at that. Okay? Yeah. We're all from WhatsApp. We're all friends, you know. Are there any questions?
Choose one action in these different examples.
Well, it's for you. This is just to get you thinking. It's more personal about what you would like to improve. It's something more specific, like maybe speaking or writing or reading. So now you want to speak to some other people and get one action that will take you one step closer to becoming better at phrasal verbs.
Thank you.